AEW, and welcome to Saturday Night Unleashed. And we are live here in Phoenix, Arizona, the last stop before DCW Vice. And the main event of the evening will determine who will be the last entrant into the Las Vegas roulette. It will either be Tony Capano, Ricky Heathen, or Eric Taylor. But for now, we do have a women's championship matchup on Saturday Night Unleashed. Coming to the ring right now was the loser of the women's championship final that was held at Summer Madness, Akumi. Making her way down to the ring. She believes that the loss she suffered at Summer Madness was a fluke, that Cassie Webb got lucky and got her down for the three count for that title. Akumi has the opportunity tonight to prove her theory and to show the world here that she is the true champion that she believes she is here in DCW. But like I said, she's not the only fierce competitor here. The champion will make her way out here shortly. Has damn well proved herself that she belongs here in DCW to make it to the final and defeat Akumi for that belt. And here comes the champion of the women's division, Cassie Webb. Now she's getting boos here in the Phoenix area. But you can't deny that as of right now, she is your women's champion. The winner of this matchup will be facing Jamie Rabbit at DCW Vice, defending that title right there. Vice is turning into a big show, with the Las Vegas Roulette having seven competitors in it to battle out for the World Championship. The winner of this matchup battling Jamie Rabbit for the Women's Championship. In a match that was made earlier today, it will be Pablo Juarez defending the Internet Championship against Casey Larkin at DCW Vice. As Cassidy is strutting her way around the ring, showing off that title. Ladies and gentlemen, this is going to be for the DCW Women's Championship. One of these two women will be going to DCW Vice to take on Jamie Rabbit. Will be that one right there, the one that believes that that belt should be hers and that she lost in a fluke. Or will it be the reigning women's champion of DCW? The woman that won the title at Summer Madness, the first ever women's champion, Cassie Webb. One of these two women gotta win tonight to make it to Vice. As Cassie's giving the belt to the referee, possibly for the last time. As the referee showing the belt to Akumi, believing that she is the true champion here at DCW. Akumi versus Cassie Webb. And here we go. Akumi's trying to go for a German. No, she got it in a takedown. And I got it in a headlock. Getting shots to the face by Akumi. Around to Cassidy. Akumi's trying to do all these technical holds on to Cassidy. I'm not sure that was a smart idea or not, because Cassidy's a very capable wrestler herself. But so far in early going, Akumi is getting a clear advantage here with a knee to the face. Irish whip. Not to the outside. Down goes Cassidy. And both of them are now outside. We're at a count of one. And Cassidy just threw Akumi right into the ring post. Trying to stop out the woman on the outside. Shot to the back by Cassidy. Ready count of three. Knee drop by Cassidy. Try to go for a cutter, and Akumi reversed it. Akumi trying to go for a German suplex, but Cassidy reversed that. Ready count of five. Cassidy with a running knee drop. Round to Akumi's head. Ready count of six. Count of seven. And she throws her into the ring post. See that count of eight. Very shortly. We're gonna be in there soon. Ready count of eight. Akumi throws Cassidy in. Akumi's back in. And Cassidy will put takedown. Akumi knew she had Cassidy back in the ring before the count of 10, or she not have won that title. But that possibly gave Cassidy the opening that she needed in the early ongoings in this matchup. Working on the back of Akumi right now. Miss Webb, as arrogant as she is your champion right now in DCW. This match is for the championship, folks. On Saturday Night Unleashed, back suplex by Cassidy. A vicious back suplex by Cassidy. And she keeps dropping those knee drops. Right on Akumi's head, going to the middle rope. Akumi's trying to get to her feet. But Cassidy's waiting hard to get up. Cassidy with a drop kick, but missed. She missed the drop kick. But Cassidy takes advantage of Akumi just standing there, throwing her to the turnbuckle, shot to the face with that vicious forearm from Cassidy. And Cassidy's trying to choke out Akumi right now. Cassidy's trying to get Akumi in a chokehold. Run the ropes, come back around, double axe handle. She missed. Akumi's back up, working the arm breaker. Akumi with a shot with a kick. Now Cassidy takes her down. Going for the cover. One count kick out of Akumi. As the crowd's coming alive here in Phoenix, Arizona tonight. Another knee drop by Cassidy. She's clearly working on the head here, Akumi, here tonight. Akumi with an uppercut. A shot to the throat. Going to the turnbuckle. Akumi trying to take her up top. She has Cassidy on top turnbuckle. Cassidy with a shot. Cassidy on the top rope and takes her down. What a reversal by Cassidy. That could have been the opening she needs to win this matchup. Going for the cover. One count kick out of Akumi. Akumi kicked out at a count of one. Cassidy still dropping those knee drops. Cassidy trying to pick up Akumi right now. She's trying to drag her across the ring. Smack there, takedown. And a vicious knee to the back. As Cassidy on the ropes gloating here, trying to tell Akumi to get up. Giving Akumi the boots. Another knee drop onto the face. This is about five or six so far in this matchup. And now she's choking out Akumi once again. A belly-to-belly suplex by Cassidy. Cassidy with a belly-to-belly suplex. One, two, three. Cassidy Webb is still your women's champion. Cassidy with a major belly-to-belly suplex to end this matchup with the one, the two, the three. And Cassidy Webb is still your DCW women's champion. Cassidy will be heading to DCW Vice to defend that title against Jamie Rabbit. That should be a great matchup at Vice. But for now, she is up top and her first title defense. Welcome back to DCW Saturday Night Unleashed, as Charles Kennedy is in the ring right now, waiting for his opponent to come out. As the king of this ring, making his way down to the ring, Leon Tyson. He has a match at DCW Vice against Robin Jackson. All because it seems like a miscommunication between him and Jackson after Jackson's match on Saturday Night Unleashed last week with Eddie Kang. But Jackson just accidentally bumped into Tyson, and Tyson didn't take that lightly and gave him a shot to the face. As Leon Tyson is slowly making his way into the ring. But Tyson has to be aware that his opponent tonight is Charles Kennedy, a man that's been on a losing streak here, who wants to try his best to make it up into at least the Internet Championship division. But Charles Kennedy gonna have a lot on his plate, considering the kind of talent that Leon Tyson's here, and he has shown and proved so far in DCW. Charles Kennedy looks ready. Leon Tyson looks ready. And here we go. Kennedy with a quick shot to the gut. Double arm hook, suplex, and he got him. Charles Kennedy doing the smart thing here and attacking first. Going quickly to Leon Tyson. But Tyson gets any type of momentum going, this match will be ending very quickly. But so far, it seems to me that Charles Kennedy has the momentum. As the British Marauder is going for a suplex, and he throws one onto the mat, giving Tyson the boots. Like I said, Tyson couldn't take this match too lightly, considering that he does have a major matchup coming up at Vice. But Tyson is back in the groove of things with that slam there. Kennedy's back up. Kennedy's trying to pick up Tyson. Trying to throw him around. Nope, Tyson reversed it. Tyson with a back suplex. Tyson being at least the king of suplexes here in DCW. With a shot to the back of the head with that forearm. And a backbreaker for good measure. All hail King Tyson, it seems he wants it to be. As he throws Kennedy over the ropes, and to the outside he goes, down to the floor. The referee starts his count of one, as Tyson's trying to pick up Kennedy. Suplex onto the floor. We're at a count of two now. As Tyson is on the outside, disrespecting Charles Kennedy. We're at a count of three. The referee's trying to tell him to get back into the ring. Tyson throws him to the barricade. We're at a count of four. And Kennedy just threw Tyson against the ring post. And another shot to the ring post. We're at a count of six now. Seven. He throws him to the ring post once again. And he finally throws Tyson back into the ring. After three shots into the ring post, Tyson is down right now. Kennedy's going up top here. Kennedy with a flying elbow drop. Right on the money. And Charles Kennedy seems to get a lot of momentum going. But Tyson's trying to get onto his feet. Kennedy with a DDT. Can Charles Kennedy pull out the upset here? With a shot to the back on the Tyson. Kennedy trying to pick up Tyson. Tyson reverses with arm drag. Going for the cover. One. One count. Kick out Kennedy. Shot by Tyson. DDT followed up with it. He followed a shot to the face with the DDT. Now Tyson onto the middle rope. Charles Cage getting to his feet. Double axe handle takedown. Tyson with a shot to the face. He got a suplexes. That's one. One back suplex. A second back suplex. Finish it off with a German. Oh, hell, King Tyson. Elbow drops. Follow with the boots. And another boot to the arm. The end could be near for Kennedy here. Kennedy with a shot to the gut. Kennedy trying to go for a belly to belly. Reversed by Tyson. DDT by Tyson. A vicious DDT by Leon Tyson. Charles trying to get to his feet. Down with the King. Down with the King. For the cover. One, two, three. Leon Tyson makes short work of Charles Kennedy. Hitting Charles Kennedy with Down with the King. Kennedy gave him a good fight, but he couldn't survive that. For the one, the two, the three. And there goes the King of this ring, Leon Tyson, as he's heading towards the vise to take on Robin Jackson. Will it be the Knockout King, or will it be the King of the Ring? Welcome everybody back to DCW. This is our main event. This match right here, we'll have one of these three men going to DCW Vice Las Vegas Roulette match as the last participant into that matchup. And being the last participant, we'll have them have the full advantage in that matchup, considering after everybody's in the ring, whoever has the last pinfall or submission in the last 10 minutes of the match will be the DCW World Champion. As Eric Taylor's in the ring, waiting on the second opponent to come out. Here comes the Hawaiian Poseidon, the Way God. Tony Capone makes his way into the ring. Both of these men so far, Eric Taylor and Tony Capone, and also Ricky Heathen, have had shots for the DCW World Championship. All three of them, man, have lost to our current champion, Will Nunn. Ricky Heathen losing to him in our first pay-per-view and unbeaten, or having Eric Taylor being defeated by Will Nunn at our second pay-per-view, Limelight, and also Tony Capone losing to Will Nunn at No Exit. You know for sure that all these men in this ring want to be the last one to come in to Las Vegas to be able to come out on top and become the DCW World Championship. We're trying to take that belt off of Will Nunn. As Tony Ziggler is right in the ring, being one of the most feared competitors here in DCW. The Hawaiian Poseidon, the Wave God. This man will clearly be the hometown favorite at DCW Vice, considering that it's in Las Vegas. The man, Ricky Heathen, making his way down to the ring. He could possibly come back to his hometown, Las Vegas, as the last entrant into the Las Vegas roulette and come out on top as a DCW champion. You know that all the competitors in the back are looking at this matchup very closely to see who the last competitor the Las Vegas roulette will be. As Ricky Heathen struts his way into the ring, that man could possibly be our new DCW World Champion. But it also could be Tony Capano. It could be Eric Taylor. It could be Jack Gunn. It could be Lance Bourne. It could be Isaac Najee. That would be the toughest match that Will Nunn's ever had. He had to start at number one and survive everybody to keep that title. And here we go in this matchup. Taylor with a quick DDT on the Heathen. And a quick takedown on the Coney. Taylor with a shot on Coney. Taylor trying to end this match very quickly. Continuing shot on the Coney. Ricky comes back around with a German suplex to take down Taylor. This match is starting off at a very high pace. But you know how important this matchup is to these three competitors. As Taylor picks up Heathen and he throws him across the ring. And now Taylor trying to set up Coney and takes him down to the mat as well. Eric Taylor, for just about the entire matchup so far, has been in complete control of both these competitors. As he throws Capone down to the mat. Irish whip by Heathen. Come back around, drop kick by Ricky Heathen. And Taylor trying to ride to the ring for a breather. So now it's just Heathen and Capone. Heathen with a backbreaker onto Capone. All three of these men have been number one contenders for that title. Springboard moonsault. Cover. One count. Kick out Capone. Taylor's back into the ring. Ricky's trying to set up Taylor now. Drops his neck into the ropes. And looks to be now that Heathen's in the driver's seat with shots and kicks and chops and shots. And Taylor countered that. Taylor going for another backbreaker into this matchup. Round to Ricky Heathen. Taylor with a running DDT on the Capone. And Capone rolls out. I don't think Capone even got an offensive maneuver in this matchup yet. As he onto the outside. Between Heathen and Taylor right now. As Heathen tries to work on the legs of Eric Taylor. Capone's back in. Capone's gonna sit on the outside of the ring, trying to bide his time. A shot by Capone. And he drops Eric Taylor's head into the turnbuckle. Ricky comes in with an arm drag, the DDT on the Taylor. Both men were equally trying to attack Taylor. But now Ricky has Capone and he drops him around his head. He dropped him on his head with that brain buster. Ricky runs the ropes. Knee drop by Ricky Heathen. Heathen's trying to get Coney off the mat. Through the grapevine. Through the grapevine by Ricky Heathen. Taylor's trying to get onto his feet. Coney is out. Taylor with a takedown. Ricky rolls to the outside. Taylor going for the cover. One, two, kick out by Coney. Two and a half before Coney kicked out. Taylor's working on Capano. As Heathen on the outside. Taylor going for another cover. Cover by Taylor. One count before Heathen broke it up. Now Heathen and Taylor going back and forth. Taylor with shots. Heathen with a shot. Taylor with a kick to the leg. A shot to the back. Eric Taylor trying to set him up. He got him up for that elevated net breaker. And then he got him. Taylor got that net breaker. Going for the cover. One, two, kick out out by Heathen. Kick out by Heathen. At 2.5. Cody's back up. Cody trying to go for a backbreaker. Terry reversed it. Heathen's down. Coastline. 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 Covered by Taylor. 1, 2, 3, no. 2.5. 2.75. Call what you will. But Cody the paddle barely kicked out. Heathen's still down. Cody's down. Terry's up. Terry with a shot on Cody. Ricky's back up. Ricky with a shot. Try to set up Taylor. And he takes him down. Going for the cover. One count kick out to Taylor. What a crazy main event has it been on Saturday Night Unleashed. Heathen's trying to go for the Garden Heathen. Like he's trying to go for the Garden Heathen, but Taylor reversed it. Taylor's trying to work with Heathen on the ropes. Throws him down to the mat. Heathen runs to that side. Cody's trying to get up. Coastline once again. Coastline again. The second one to Cody. Heathen's on the outside. 1, 2, 3. Aaron Taylor will be the last man entering into Las Vegas roulette. It seemed that Ricky Heathen might have had a one with that through the grapevine, but it took 2 coastlines to take out Cody Gopano. And that Aaron Taylor be the victor here. Aaron Taylor has the ultimate advantage at DCW Vice. That man right there, the leader of Fortitude, could possibly be the leader of DCW and be your new DCW World Champion. Wait a minute, oh! He got dropped. Borkick! Lance Borkick out of nowhere! Hit Aaron Taylor with a Borkick. Taylor's trying to get to his feet. Lance is waiting on him. Another Borkick! 2 Borkicks have laid out Aaron Taylor. Could that man be your new world champion? Wait a minute. Jack Gunn's in the ring. Backbreaker by Jack Gunn on the Lance Bourne. Now Jack Gunn's working on Bourne. Shot to the gut. Shot to the back by Dunn. Pandemonium is just ensuing here. It's starting to unleash. Gunn is just destroying Bourne right here. And here comes the elbow ball. Elbow ball by Jack Gunn. As he's in the ring celebrating. Wait a minute. Isaac with a drop kick with the top rope. Where did he come from? Najee from the top rope. Najee with a quick takedown. A shot to the face. Double axe handle. Isaac Najee, the man that was so close to winning the title back in Summer Madness. He's trying to tear Jack Gunn apart before Vice drop kick again. Drop kick to the back of Jack Gunn. Najee going to the top. He's going for the Arabian Flight. Arabian Flight. Arabian Flight by Najee. Najee's trying to tell him to get up. Najee picks up Gunn off the mat. Gunn is messing dead way at this point. Whoa! He's got a message to Ricky Heathen. He just did a Garden Heathen flat cutter. Riding a gun. And a second Arabian Flight. A second Arabian Flight by Isaac Najee. We have a new DCW champion. We'll see you at Vice.